Ok. Industrial Engineering Chemical Resources 1993. Ok. Now, there are several parasite reactions in these papers, but we focus only on the three main reactions: etilbenzene to stirene, etilbenzene to benzene, etilbenzene to toluene.
Ok.
Ok. Allora, we open up an additional reaction in D. Ethylbenzene dilatation power law. We choose the type general because it is more flexible. Irene, hydrogen 1-1, reaction reversible, reaction class power law. The second, in this case, is not reversible. And the third parasite reaction etilbenzene toluene. Ok, this one.
Ok.
Ok, now the reacting phase is of course vapor. For the other things, we have to search within the article. Allora, we see this is the table for the parameters. The activation energy are in kilojoule on kilomoles, while for the reaction rate, sì, nomenclature. Allora, nomenclature. Reaction rate constant. Kilomol, chilogrammi ora bar. Ok, guys. This means that the concentration basis for the reactor is the partial pressure
Ok.
in bar. And the rate basis is the catalyst weight. And the reaction rate units are kilomoles of reactant per kilogram of catalyst in an hour.
Ok.
Now, for the first reaction, allora, if you read the article, you discover that there are two reaction rates for every reaction, because the authors make two different calculations. One considering the diffusion of the gases inside a reaction pellet, and one not considering this phenomenon. So Aspen Plus reactor model does not consider diffusion inside the catalyst pellet. So we use the kappa apparent. Ok, so first reaction 3.27. activation energy 0.909 E5 kilojoule su kilomol. Ok. Allora, now click on driving force. Compute reverse rate using microscopic reversibility. The order for etilbenzene in the first reaction is one. Is one for etilbenzene. Ok. Reaction reversible. Compute reverse rate using microscopic reversibility. So, using these options, this calculation is carried automatically by Aspen Plus.
Okay.
Now, for the second reaction, we have same stuff. E29 activation energy 1 for the driving force.
Messo le libre della reaction rate, unità di misura.
Scusa?
Ci sono le libre.
Sorry. Thank you. Allora, for the reaction order, we have reaction 2, etilbenzene to 1. You can leave blank all the rest. Because Aspen interpret as zero. Number three. Vapor. Partial pressure. Var. Catalyst weight. Mass kilogram hour 72 e 3 0 1. Allora, driving force in this case we have ethyl benzene and the hydrogen in the driving force. Ok, in this case we don't have absorption denominators. Ok, now we browse the article to see if there are indications on the conversion respect to the contact time. So, for example, this article says that for a molar flow rate of 20 kilomoles per hour of etilbenzene, we should have a conversion of 50%. In which condition? 850 Kelvin, 2 bars, more or less. So, il temperature and outlet temperature. The reaction set is globally endothermic.
Yes.
Okay. So the higher the conversion, the lower the exit temperature. Mm. The inlet temperature is more than 900 Kelvin. So this amounts to 650 Celsius.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. So let's try to simulate this total molar flow rate of nearly 500 kilomoles per hour and
in such a yield.
Allora, this molar flow rate, it's the ethylbenzene at the exit of the reactor, not at the inlet. Okay?
Yeah.
So, we should look inside to discover how much water is fed together with the ethylbenzene. Okay. Molar feed rate. Steam 450, ethylbenzene 37. Okay.
Okay.
How much catalyst is loaded inside the reactor? Okay, then we can estimate the catalyst load from this table.
Mm-hmm.
The diameter of the reactor is nearly 2 meters and the length is 1.7 meters.
Okay.
So, more or less 1.7 per 1.95 per 1.95 per, allora, more or less 5 cubic meters of reactor.
Okay.
The density more or less of 2 tons per cubic meter.
Oh,
okay. So we don't have the information of how the porosity is discounted, okay? Because the authors don't say if this density is calculated on the average. That's to say on the packing as it is, or if it is the solid density and the porosity accounts for a decreased density. You understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So we don't know if this is the bulk density of the solid only, or if it is the apparent density of the whole bed. Is it clear in these terms?
Mm-hmm.
E volete che lo ripeto in italiano? Cioè, questa è la densità del solido o è la densità apparente del reattore caricato?
Ok.
Mi seguite adesso?
Sì.
Capito cosa intendo?
Dovrebbe essere però, quella, guardando la formula, a me viene da pensare quella del, cioè del reattore caricato.
Guardando quale formula?
No, no, le dimensioni, scusami. Vedi che dice che è chilogrammi di catalizzatore nella tabellina sempre, divisi per metri cubi.
Che allora... Io la densità di un solido te la posso benissimo dare in chili per metri cubi, qual è il problema?
Sì, no, pensavo che fosse chilogrammi di catalizzatore, okay, appunto divisi per il volume.
Rho C, guys, is the density of the catalyst particle. Rho C,
okay, a posto.
Not the density of the catalyst bed. This is the mm-hmm. density of the catalyst particle.
We have to account ourselves for porosity.
So, yeah. If this is the density of the catalyst particle, this is the higher density, not the lower one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
If the reactor is 5 cubic meters, The density of the pellet is 2 tons per cubic meters.
Mm-hmm.
So if the bed were packed without void fraction, there should be more or less 10 tons of catalyst.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If we assume a void fraction of 0.5, there are not 10 tons of catalyst, but just 5.
Okay.
Yes.
So we build a test reactor using the block reactor.
So non possiamo cambiare la reazione dentro il reattore, dirgli usa l'altro.
Ah, no,
until for a catalyst loading of more or less, we start with 5 tons and a bed voidage of 0.5. Be sure to select these two options. Then reactions, we use the new reaction set.
Okay.
The configuration for now is meaningless because we do a first test. Specification, allora, we want to run with a reactor at fixed temperature for now.
Yes.
So we make an average between 922 and 85. And the average is more or less 880 Kelvin.
886.
Thank you. Now,
yes.
The feed.
Okay. Yes.
We build up a test feed using these specifications. 2 bars, let's say, or 2 and 4, whatever. This benzene and this water.
Mm.
Allora, you can give it which temperature you want, because the temperature will be changing in the reactor. Just be sure that is a temperature high enough to have water as a steam. So, 37 kilomoles hours of benzene.
Idea. Però 150.
And 450 of water, more or less.
Ok.
Ok, we see what it happens. Ah, ah, ah.
Oh, nessun errore.
Allora, the simulation runs smooth, so this means that there are no very, very big mistakes. Now, let's see if the results are reasonable. Allora, I don't get a 50% conversion of ethyl benzene as stated in the article. I get a conversion less than 30%. Okay, guys?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
But remember what are our assumptions. First of all, I used just the 2 atmospheres of pressure instead of the 2.4. This is important. Why? Because we have the reaction rate in pressure. Okay.
Yes.
So now I try to correct this fact respect to the paper and I see what happens. You see a little variation.
Yes.
Now, what is the other assumption? We didn't know the packing.
Okay.
So I supposed that the bed void fraction is 50%. And so I loaded the reactor with 5 tons of catalyst instead of 10. Now, I start by calculating the actual reactor loading if the reactor had no void fraction. Okay. 10 tons, 0.9. Now, if the reactor had a void fraction of, let's say, 0.4 instead of 0.5, the loading would be 6 tons and a half. So, within the reactor, six point five, bad boy at 0.4. Notice one thing, until this options is active, the bad voidage is meaningless.
Okay.
But I write here just to have a reminder. Because if I disabilitate these options, now the bad voidage is meaningful.
We would have to write 10 ton.
We will see in a moment. Now I want to, fix the right catalyst quantity.
Okay.
So I try to run again the simulation. I look at the result. More flows. I convert 14 out of 37. That means Thirty-8%. According to the paper, the conversion should be
47,
not 38. Allora. If the reactor has a void fraction of 0.3, now I should have 7.6 tons of catalyst. You see that very, very often you don't have all the information that you need in a single paper. You have to do some trial and error calculation. This situation is very common, guys. Don't worry.
Okay.
Before pushing more catalyst in the reactor, decreasing the bad fraction, we start to check if maybe what are the pressure drops with this catalyst configuration? Okay. Allora, the author says that they calculated the pressure drop with the Ergon equation. So go inside your reactor setup and we start specifying the correct reactor dimensions.
Okay.
Allora, length 1.7 and diameter 1.95.
Okay.
Now, catalyst. We don't ignore the catalyst volume residence time anymore. We go to pressure. Calculate pressure. Allora, use frictional correlator to calculate pressure drop. Ergon. Allora, this is the roughness of the reactor wall. But you can leave it as it is.
Okay.
The important thing becomes here, the particle geometry. This has a big effect on the pressure drop calculation. So, the particle geometry, allora, is a catalyst particle has a diameter of 4.7 millimeters.
Yes.
We have a inlet pressure of 2.4 bar. We should have an outlet pressure of 2.3.
Okay.
Now we will adjust in the same time the pressure drop and conversion, acting on two different parameters. So let's come back in the reaction ED.
Yes.
The power law one.
Of course.
Pick up the tab activity. Define activity with value one. And then we accelerate any reaction by this number. Okay. So I got two low conversion specifying the reactor with the numbers stated in the article. Now I want to speed up the reaction rate in this way. Why am I doing this? Because I don't want to modify the constants. Because in the article, I found all the numbers for the reactor constant. So I guess, guys, that the difference between my calculation and the paper calculation is somewhere else, probably in the reactor loading. Ci siete come concetto? So,
non si è sentito.
If I want to account for some factor that I don't know, I manipulate the reactor constant in this way. The concept is I don't want to change the numbers of the K parameters because in the article,
yes,
these values are quite clear. On the other hand, this paper doesn't say what is the actual reactor loading to achieve this conversion. So I started in a first moment to play with the reactor loading to achieve the right conversion. But now, if I want to calculate the pressure drops, I cannot stuff catalyst inside the reactor until I get the desired conversion because I would get a too high pressure drop. So you have to keep in mind that I have still a degree of freedom available. Ci siete? Allora, io vi sto facendo questo esempio di retrofitting dei dati di un articolo con una cinetica di reazione. Perché? Perché è il caso più frequente. La gente quando fa gli articoli di cinetica si perde un po' via. È già la seconda volta che lo vediamo. E in più il reattore in Aspen è il blocco modellato peggio. Però non pensate che anche altri aspetti della simulazione non abbiano bisogno di questo retrofitting. Cioè, nelle informazioni che trovate c'è qualcosa di mancante. O perché gli autori si sono dimenticati di scriverlo, o perché agli autori sembrava troppo ovvio, o perché non è una conoscenza che vogliono divulgare. Okay.
Ma poi questo parametro che noi mettiamo per far quadrare le cose, come lo giustifichiamo?
Moment, guy. Okay. We run the simulation and we see what happens. Allora, too high pressure drop, you see?
Well, 2.1 and should be 2.3. Yes.
The pressure drop is relatively high. Probably I've got too much catalyst in the reactor. Now you see that adjusting the activity, the conversion, it's even higher than those stated in the article.
Okay.
Now I start to correct another aspect of my simulation. Okay. I don't want to have a reactor with fixed temperature, but an adiabatic reactor. An adiabatic reactor is a reactor that does not receive or release heat. So if the reaction is endothermic, the reactive stream gets colder. If the reaction is exothermic, the reactive stream gets hotter.
Okay.
Allora, when I run with this option, guys, I must be careful. I have to adjust the feed temperature to match the actual one. Otherwise...
The one of the reactor.
No.
900.
The one no, yes. The yes, the feed...
window. Okay, let's do another try.
Okay.
Allora, look at the results.
There is still a big
okay.
drop.
The conversion is more or less as I expected, but the pressure drop are still relatively high. Now, let's see what happens if I put in the reactor just 6.5 ton with a void fraction of 0.4. Okay, the conversion is in line. The pressure drop is in line. Now let's look at the temperatures. Wow. Perfect. So, guys, we have retrofitted correctly this paper. Just assuming that these reaction rates have to be multiplied by 2. So probably we should have used the intrinsic rate instead of the apparent one. Probably. Now let's do another check. Let's control the selectivities. Okay.
Okay.
The selectivity to styrene should be some like 90%. Anyway, we have also the molar flow rates. The molar flow rate of the benzene at the exit should be 19. And I have 18.
Yeah.
The molar flow rate of styrene, it's around 16, and I have around 16. Wow. Toluene, now one, and benzene, a little more than one. I have these two things inverted. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, benzene is okay. I have too much toluene exiting from my reactor.
Mm-hmm.
So,
no, too little toluene.
Tu ce l'hai giusto?
No, il toluene nel paper è 2 e noi ne abbiamo 1.
Yeah, too little. Okay. We fix this issue promptly, activity, etilbenzene to toluene. Allora, we define another activity, A2, let's say. We give it the value of 3, why not? Or even 4.
Okay.
And we assign it to the third reaction.
Okay.
Now, pressure drop, fine. Temperature, fine. Etilbenzene, in line. Sfirene, pretty fine. Benzene, ok. Toluene, slightly less than what is a
non
ok. If I want to spaccare il capello, if I want to be more precise, I write 4.5 here and I'm done. Ok. This flowsheet deserves to be saved. Allora, when we did the simplified flowsheet, remember the how to say the simplified reaction scheme with the virtual blocks, guys?
Yes.
That seems.
Allora, we supposed a conversion of 30% per each stage of reaction. Remember?
Yes.
Now we are going with a higher conversion. See? Now we are reaching a conversion of nearly 50%. Mi seguite?
Yes.
Mm. Now, what should we do? We can keep the new results or fall back to the global the global conversion that we specified before. Now, remember that our original feed was 120 kmol per hour of etilbenzene. Ci siete?
Mm-hmm.
Allora, now we are using for our test reactor 37 kmol per hour of etilbenzene. So, 1/4. So, the first problem we have to face now is the scale up. Allora, from now on, guys, I save the flowsheet with another name. Mi seguite?
Sì.
And I delete the old scheme with the simplified mass balances to reduce the number of blocks that I have in the flowsheet and to make things simpler. Ok? You do what you want. Se volete, buttatelo via, se no, no.
Ok, I have a question. Noi con lo stream che usciva dal secondo reattore stechiometrico abbiamo fatto un'operazione di transfer che poi andava nell'heat exchanger. Cosa
bravo,
facciamo?
In effetti, se tu cancelli gli altri blocchi,
sì,
vedi che il transfer non funziona più.
Mm-hmm.
Ok. Allora, tu prendi questo stream qua e fai il reconcile.
Ok.
Oppure lo definisci ab inizio, non okay, è un problema.
Mettiamo dentro questo stream i dati di quello che era il feed iniziale? O
allora, cioè, se hai i risultati caricati, fai il reconcile.
Perfetto.
Se non hai i risultati caricati, in genere c'è sempre Simone che ci dà di fare il target.
In questo momento il mio Aspen credo sia esploso per il mio tentativo di fare cose.
Eh beh, certo. E il transport si cancella.
Perfetto, grazie.
Questo è proprio meglio cancellarlo, non disattivarlo.
Ok, perché potrebbe comunque tenere i dati e dare errore successivamente.
Sì, e anche perché potrebbe darsi che Aspen all'inizio della simulazione faccia un check per vedere che tutte le cose siano state definite decentemente. E allora in quel caso, anche se il transfer è disattivo, lui lo vede definito male e comincia a dare messaggi di errori. È una cosa che capita anche con le sensitivity e con le reazioni. Okay. Cioè, se uno scrive male una reazione, ad esempio perché sbaglia la stechiometria, no? Perché vabbè, se scrivi male la cinetica, Aspen non se ne accorge. Ma se scrivi male la stechiometria, sì. E poi quella reazione non la usa, ma la stechiometria è scritta male. Quando lui fa il controllo all'inizio che tutti i dati siano scritti decentemente, manda messaggi d'errore.
Ok, abbiamo capito perché venivano ricevuti dei messaggi d'errore nella prima parte della lezione.
Ah, perché non sapete la stechiometria? Ah, potevi anche non dirmelo allora, guarda.
No, la mia era giusta, però era un problema che ci portavamo dietro da ieri.
Mannaggia voi altri. Allora, guys, 120 kmol per hour of ethyl benzene. I want at least a 30% conversion in the first stage.
Ok.
But I know that if I use 120 kmol per hour in the reactor, that now I name it React 1, I would have in return at least 60 kmol per hour of ethyl benzene from the recycle column. Ok. Gesem.
Mm-hmm.
So, I start doing things in the correct order. Allora, let's refer once again to the original paper.
Okay.
To the original flow sheet. Allora, we have the fresh feed. We have the recycle injection.
Okay.
Then we have steam. Then we have a heat exchanger. Then we have steam at a higher temperature that is put after the heat exchanger.
Okay.
Allora, this structure is relatively complex and derives from energy optimization issues.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Allora, you yes. see that the thermal balance of the blocks E1 and E2 is fixed. What changes is the way in which the energy is distributed. Probably because, sì, ho capito. Va bene, then, let's try to consider first we will build things here in a slightly different way. Okay? So,
okay.
First of all, we start with the feed. Then, guys, we need a mixer to inject the recycle. Then, mixer splitter, pick up a mix. Allora. And then we prepare a test recycle.
How did you prepare the recycle? Sorry.
It's I added the string.
Ah, okay.
Allora, the recycle, it's 150 degrees. But I feed it at, let's say, 2.5 bar. I place inside here just 63 kilomoles per hour of benzene, nothing else. Oh, the fresh feed, 220 degrees. Four bars. Okay, then also the pressure of the recycle must be raised to 4 bars. Perfect. Now, a steam injection. Allora, you see, this steam injection is 600 kilomoles per hour out of 3,400. Okay. So as a matter of fact, as a first approximation, we can neglect it. We model just the main steam injection line. See? Allora, so we place two heat exchangers and then the steam injection. We need two heat exchangers and one mixer. Allora, exchangers, one. Another heat exchangers for the steam. And another mixer. Okay.
Un secondo che.
Now I need the steam. I connect the steam to the mixer. And I'm almost ready. So I can reconnect the reactor feed. I change its name. Okay. Allora, the fresh feed is defined. The recycle is defined. The steam not. Allora, steam, remember, 3,400 kilomoles per hour of water at 200 degrees and 4 bars. The heat exchanger number one and heat exchanger number two. Allora, what's the point? They have to provide enough energy to go inside the reactor at more or less 650 degrees. So we can copy down this data, or we just go to, or we just, or we can go with the trial and error procedure. Okay. For example, if I copy the data of the article, I can have here a temperature of 500. While on the steam side, a temperature of 750, let's say. Now, the pressure drop. For now, I put zero pressure drops in the heat exchangers. I use the mixer number 2 to regulate the pressure at the reactor inlet. So I assume, guys, that all the pressure drop take place inside the mixer, even if it is not true. Okay? Let's start like this. Ci siamo?
Un po' di pezzi devo recuperarli.
Sì, intanto guardo se funziona.
Allora, cosa devo definire?
Allora, results available with warnings. The reactor has yielded several warnings. Let's see why. Results. Status. Pressure has fallen below 10 newton square meter in the reactor. Zero pressure drop will be assumed at downstream location in the reactor. Ok, very, very good. Very, very good, guys. This is a typical problem that one encounters when he's doing a scale-up of the reactor. Ok? What is the reason of this error? The reason is that we are flowing 3,000 and 500 kilomoles per hour into a reactor that was sized to handle less than 500 kilomoles per hour. Ok?
Ok.
Chiaro? So, roughly, I will have to multiply by 5, at least, no, 7, the reactor volume. Got it?
Ok.
So, more or less, I will need a column with a double diameter and 150% of length.
Ok.
More or diciamo less.
4 di diametro e 2,5 di length.
Typically. This is just a for instance. Ok? Le temperature, the temperatures that I specified as in these two heat exchangers are not mandatory. The really important thing is to keep 650 or something similar at the reactor inlet. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, because we're still using the adiabatic reactor, so the important thing is that we reach that temperature at that level.
Yes, but not only it is important to reach the right temperature here. This is also more important than the temperatures that you give here. Okay. So you can change these numbers as you want, provided that this is good enough. So for example, at first instance, you should also design your heat exchangers like this. Okay. 600 and 600, 650 and 650 each. Allora, in the original paper, the temperatures after the heat exchangers are very different. Okay. 487 and 777. Allora, don't bother about this. Because this situation is common in real plants. Why? Because here at A1, I'm using an external heat source. While E2 is a regenerative heat exchanger. So the temperature levels at which the heat is exchanged are very, very, very different. This will be the subject of another lesson another day, okay? The basic design that fixes just the enthalpy can be done like this. Why? Because this design, even if it is the most stupid design in the world, the most obvious, brings you to have zero mixing enthalpy in the mixer. So the designer can focus just on the heat exchangers to calculate the thermal balance without considering latent heat exchanges in the mixer. Okay, this will be the topic of another lesson another day. Now it's time to resize the reactor. Okay, roughly the volume will have to be sevenfold. So for example, we could multiply the diameter by 2 and the length by 1.5, something like that. So roughly 4 meter of diameter, mm-hmm. And
1.5.
Sì, facciamo 3 meters of length.
3 meters.
Now, how much catalyst can go inside if the bed voidage is 0.4? Allora, we calculate the volume. So, 3 × 4 × 0.5. Okay, we have 37 cubic meter. Okay. The catalyst density was 2.1 tons per cubic meter. So 79 tons of catalyst, but we have to remember that the bed voidage is 0.4. So the actual catalyst loading is the 60% of this value. 47 tons of catalyst. Okay. Now, let's see what happens in the reactor.
Why doesn't Aspen calculate it on its own if we give it the amount of catalyst and the voidage?
Infatti, cosa ho fatto io, scusa?
No, I mean, if we input it this way.
Scusa?
allora, ho capito male io, ma io avevo capito che se noi, se impostavamo il bad voidage, lui prendeva, tipo con 0,4, toglieva il 40% di 47. O no?
No, perché? Perché le tue reazioni chimiche sono definite sulla massa di catalizzatore, non sul volume di reattore.
Forse ho capito. È un'altra cosa quella a cui si riferisce il bad boy.
Simone, tu la densità del catalizzatore ad Aspen non gliel'hai detta da nessuna parte.
Ah, è vero. Ok, no. Sì.
Tac, zio.
Giusto anche questo.
Ok, no, let's see what our reactor has done. Allora, the pressure drop is a little high, but we are on the right way. Yes. Cazzarola, cioè io veramente parlo in inglese come penso in italiano, veramente un scandalo. Ethyl benzene conversion is... it's high, but it's less than it's less than 50%. So, maybe yes. Allora, we can also see that we are converting 100 moles of ethyl benzene. The selectivity to styrene is 87%. While the selectivity to benzene and toluene is 1/10. This is more or less in line with this data, roughly. Okay, yield 40%, yield between 3 and 4% for the parasite reaction. Okay, now we are experiencing relatively high pressure drops, but also and also a high conversion. We are also experiencing, guys, a appreciable temperature drop because the reaction is endothermic, so the higher the conversion, the higher the temperature drop.
Mm-hmm.
So we should decrease the catalyst, or we should decrease the catalyst and also decrease the reactor length. If we decrease the reactor length, we get less pressure drops. And if we decrease the catalyst, we get less conversion, and so and maybe we get a conversion of 30% as in the beginning. Okay.
Okay.
If we need to reduce the pressure drops more than we need to reduce the conversion, we also increase the diameter. So, allora, I start decreasing the length, let's say 2.8, anzi 2.5. Allora, 2.5 divided by 3. This means that I have to decrease the catalyst by this factor. So, this is the new catalyst quantity, 39. I see what happens.
Mm-hmm. there is still a big pressure drop.
There is still a high pressure drop. Now, the conversion is...
more than 50%.
53%. Still very high. Ok. Allora, beware of one thing. I cannot go on indefinitely decreasing the length and increasing the diameter. Otherwise, my reactor bed would not have the enough depth to avoid bypass effects.
Okay.
So, it is possible that I would have to correct the void function. It is possible that I would have to correct the void function. For example, if, allora, usually one doesn't want to correct the void fraction because the void fraction depends on how the catalyst is shaped. Okay. But we can imagine that one can manage the overall void fraction of the bed acting about also on how the catalyst particle are loaded in the bed. If there are spacing grids, displacers, and so on. So for example, let's try with a bed voidage of 0.5. If the bed voidage is 0.5 and we have 39 tons of catalyst, let's also decrease the catalyst to 30 tons. Allora, 30 tons with the density of 2.1 tons per cubic meter would occupy 14 cubic meters. But now my void fraction is 0.5. So the actual volume is 28 cubic meters. 28. Now, let's suppose that the length is 2.5. 28 divided 2.5, we get 11 square meters. Allora, this number times 4 divided pi greco under square. 3.7 meters. Let's see what happens with these new assumptions. Okay, so now the pressure drop is acceptable. And the conversion is lower. I mean, I am converting 88 kmol per hour of ethyl benzene out of 183. So I have a conversion of 48%. The conversion is still high.
I have more ethyl benzene. How much did you place in the starting feed?
The original, the value that we calculated the first day, 120 kmol per hour.
Ah, I use 152.
Then there is also the recycle, 63.
Okay, the recycle, I got it from the
okay,
other.
Okay, I have a 48 conversion. I stay with this value for now, and I see what it happens after I add the second reactor stage.
Okay.
Okay. Now, The reaction mixture must be reheated to 650 degrees. So I add another heat exchanger. I assume that there are no pressure drops in the heat exchangers. Then I pick up another reactor block, air plug, and I specify it is actually the same way as the other for now. Then we will see what happens. Okay, reactor type adiabatic. Configuration 2.5, 3.74, for example. Reaction, the power law set, pressure, frictional correlation, ergun. Catalyst, catalyst present, okay, 30 tons, for example, bed void 0.5, particle geometry 4.7 millimeters.
Che dimensione abbiamo usato per il reattore?
Le stesse dell'altro.
Ah, le stesse dell'altro.
Ok, I run the simulation. Allora, I can see that the reactor behaves more or less as I expected. So I have acceptable pressure drops. And I have nearly 50% conversion. Now, siamo tutti fin qua?
Un secondo.
Thank you, manca.
Allora, let's start to consider it. Allora, we are about, guys, to close the recycle, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So we have two options now. The first option is to close the recycle here at the reactor exit.
Mm-hmm.
And use this stream as a tear stream. The second option is to close this connection between the ethylbenzene recycle and use the reactor exit as a tear stream. Do you understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
No. Yeah, can't. Allora, I don't make the two connections at the same time.
Yes.
I make one at a time. Which I do first? Allora, this is not easy to decide. Allora, one starts to look at what has around. Allora, we compare the streams. Allora, this was my foreseen reactor exit. Okay. While now this is my real reactor exit. Okay. Okay. Much less ethyl benzene. More or less same toluene and benzene. More, much more styrene. And more or less the same other stuff. Now let's compare the column recycle. With the actual one. Okay. In this case, the only difference is the residual quantity of styrene. Got it.
Mm-hmm.
So, if I close if I do this connection, I will have to rework the separation section. If I close this connection, the reactor will be unaffected. Okay. Pronto?
Mm-hmm.
Allora, it's not very easy to decide. It's not very easy to decide. Allora, let's start by adding another heat exchanger here for now. Allora, HX4. Why that? Allora, because out of the reactor exit a superheated gas stream. While in the decanter, we have a mixture well below the dew point. Okay. So it's good practice to account for such a process in at least two stages. One stage to reach the dew point and one stage to do the subcooling. So this additional heat exchanger will be specified with a zero pressure drop. And then let's say with the 5 degrees of superheating. Okay. Okay, raga, this may not be very easy, eh? We may have problems to close this recycle. Because when we close the recycle with the virtual blocks, you saw that everything went fine. But now we have two Radfrak distillation columns online. Okay. This is not a trivial matter. So we start closing the recycle here. So, first of all, we save the flowsheet with a different name. Okay. Allora, we delete this stream and we reconnect this one. Okay. I expect some problems in the distillation columns. Okay, guys.
I already have those.
run the simulation? Yes. We see what happens. Okay, the distillation columns failed. Allora, but luckily they did not fail in a too bad way. Allora, the main problem for both columns is that the internal design specification is not satisfied. Nevertheless, the calculation managed to converge. So, things are not as bad as they could be. Quindi, calma e sangue freddo, ci armiamo di santa pazienza. Ok, guys.
Allora, sono le specifiche del
first della... of all, we look at what comes out of the decanter. Ok.
Quali sono le specifiche
dell'interno? Simone, sta zitto un attimo e segui me. Allora, out of the decanter we have 26% of ethyl benzene, while we had foreseen 33%. This is because the reactors are converting much more ethyl benzene of what expected. Okay, this is not too bad. Toluene and benzene are more or less the same. Styrene is has a much higher value. So probably the first column has to be resized according to this new data. Allora, now let's see what didn't was not good in the first column. Allora, presence. The purity is higher than what expected. The reflux ratio is at a bound. While the recovery is much lower than what expected. And the second distillation column is probably out of specification as a consequence. So we have much more styrene around to cope with. So I start trying to specify differently the first column. I increase the bottom to feed ratio. And I also change the design specification boundary. I decrease the target. Cos'è che volevi dirmi, Simone?
No, mi mancavano delle specifiche del flussismo.
Io te l'ho dato.
Ma le ho messe e penso che siano giuste.
Cos'è che ti mancava?
Gli heat exchangers, gli ultimi due.
Hai capito il discorso che ho fatto, no?
Adesso...
Uno per arrivare al punto di rugiada e l'altro per arrivare alla temperatura che vuoi.
Quindi il primo abbiamo messo degrees of superheating.
E cosa dici che ti mancava?
No, il pressure drop è zero, quindi zero entra.
Now, the first column is still out of the requirements, but the second works. So, allora, in this case, the recovery is in line. But the purity is lower than what expected. So, allora, we have to choose if we have to choose the trade-off between recovery and purity. If we increase the reflux ratio, we get a higher purity, but increase also the reboiler duty. If we decrease the recovery, we get an higher purity and we also decrease the reboiler duty. Allora, the point is that in the real styrene process, this stream has to go to a polymerizator. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, we should aim for purity more than for recovery.
Okay.
On the other side, let's see that this column has started to behave in a sensitively different way than what expected. See, guys, allora, in this, from the second columns, we are letting out etilbenzene and styrene with a low purity of etilbenzene and also much more or less etilbenzene that were initially foreseen. So we before working again on the first column, we have to notice that our recycle, guys, is starting to be very, very different from the actual recycle. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So it is time to start manually changing the recycle stream. Let's type 50 instead of 63 and allow 1 kmol per hour of styrene. And let's see what happens now. Okay. The column number one is still calculated correctly. The error message is due to the fact that doesn't meet the target requirements. Okay, we had 49 to 63. Now we have 51 to 45. We are losing etilbenzene in the cycle. If I closed the recycle now, I would get a depletion of etilbenzene from the flow sheet. Because I have a very high conversion in the reactor. Allora, probably I should work on the reactors and decrease the conversion. Allora, the pressure drops are not very high, so configuration, I decrease the length. And I decrease the catalyst loading. Okay, 26. And I do the same in the two reactor. Okay, still errors. Because, okay, the columns don't meet the target requirements as usual. Nevertheless, now I am more unreacted etilbenzene. Okay? And this is not bad at all. Allora, column 1. Ok, I just should increase the purity.
A me la purity me la dà, è troppo elevata, 0,9993.
It depends also on what is your recovery.
The recovery is 80%.
Ok, nevertheless, the first column, almost. Well, the second column, we have I'm losing too much etilbenzene in the overheads. I have to increase the etilbenzene recovery. Definitely.
Okay.
Okay, let's try to see if this happens. I have also to fix the purity of this column. Unfortunately, I'm afraid they have to increase the reflux ratio. Now I don't get errors, and I see if the results are good. Okay, guys, you can appreciate that now also the recycled etilbenzene and the forcing recycle stream starts to be closer. Sì. The problem is that I have too much styrene and too few etilbenzene. Because the reactor's conversion, guys, is much more higher than what expected before. Okay. Pronto?
Sì.
Allora, a convenient way to decrease conversion at this stage, guys, could be to reduce the reactor temperature. Okay. Allora, to increase the temperature, it's a cost. So if I keep the conversion low, decreasing the temperature, because I have less activation energy, I reduce the costs. Okay?
Yes.
For example, let's start at 620 instead of 650. And we do also the same in the second reactor. Okay, let's see what happens. Got it. Now I have much more etilbenzene around, even much more than what I initially ok, avete capito, cazzo. Ok? So, we see that tuning the reactor temperature is a very, very effective strategy to keep the process balances. Okay, now the second column is again some issue. Oh, very, very nice. See? I just need to see what is happening to my idea, second column. A poor recovery, probably because this specification is at the bound. A poor recovery. Probably there's allora, vediamo un po' if this column can be helped also by an increase of the reflux ratio. No. Unfortunately, reflux ratio doesn't seem to have a big effect. The second column, the first column, con che recovery state andando nella prima colonna, guys?
Io ho messo, aspetta che ci arrivo.
Allora, I try to go for a higher recovery than 96%.
Io ce l'ho 0,98 il recovery, okay, good. Con un bottom to feed ratio calcolato di, non mi ha fatto l'anno. L'upper bound è 0,6, però mi ricordo che era tipo 0,4 qualcosa.
Thank you for the suggestion. I'm trying to do something similar.
Però ho dovuto mettere il reflux ratio a 8 invece che 7.
I also increased the reflux ratio. Okay. I know. Okay. Yes, to work on column one before is not a bad idea. Let's try. Less styrene. Oh. The problem is the purity. When recovery is increased, purity may not be met. The error is not high. Nevertheless, the reflux ratio is. Now, the second column has still problems of recovery.
I end up with a first reflux ratio of 7.95. Mm-hmm. But I meet the purity requirement. And the recovery.
Now, the second column, it's very hard for the second column to meet the plan and recovery.
To meet the recovery, I had to go to 0.88 bottom to feed ratio.
Okay, thank you for the suggestion. I will try that. You can appreciate how switching from a naive reactor to a kinetic reactor has changed our changed our project and our column specification. I mean, the global mass balances of the flow sheet are more or less the same, but the column design is more complicated. Mm-hmm. Now, if I'm going back again with this etilbenzene, look, I have to check carefully how the reactors behave, because now, you see, I'm again with 64. So, okay, let's see what happens to our dear columns. Wow, le colonne hanno tenuto botta. Now let's see the difference between the forcing recycle and the actual recycle. You see? If I want to decrease the ethylbenzene in the return, I still can play, guys, with the reactor temperatures. Okay? If I heat up this stuff, I'm going to burn some ethylbenzene. This will deplete the recycle from ethylbenzene, but will produce more styrene, and so place a higher duty on the recovery of the first column. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
It's not an easy task. So, let me try, for example, a little warm-up of these things and see how the first column behaves. I didn't got such a big variation. Okay. Control panel. Allora, I saved the file and I tried to close the recycle. Okay.
Okay.
Allora, you see that we are at 1.4 bar, we have to rise at 4, so we need a pump. Okay, I connect the streams. Allora, yes, sì. Reconnect source and reconnect destination. The pump can be specified with its discharge pressure. Now, I go to convergence, tier, and I select the recycle as my tier stream. Okay?
Si è bloccato salvando, ma ci sono.
Allora, allora, this tolerance is quite tight. I mean, I expect troubles because the tolerance is quite tight. Nevertheless, allora, we start step by step and see what happens.
No, ho perso tutto.
capita. Prova a fare un restore.
Come si fa?
Cioè, Aspint è crashato, no?
Sì, si è, ecco, è chiuso. Mentre
se
salvavo.
Tu vai nella cartella dove avevi il salvato il file l'ultima volta, dovresti avere un alias del file con un dollaro nel nome.
Un file temporaneo?
Sì, e magari anche una cartella. Prova un po' a vedere cosa hai.
È una cartella. Era pienissima di roba.
Oh, ok, guys. This is the errors at the start of the second iteration. 300. Could be worse. The good thing of this workshop, guys, maybe it will sound strange, but I can assure you that the good things of this workshop is that the columns are relatively easy. Okay. 250. The error has decreased at the start of the second iteration. Cioè, se tutte le colonne di Aspen fossero così, cioè, sembrano le colonne che ti fanno vedere le dimostrazioni su YouTube dell'Aspen Tech. Tu schiacci play e la colonna converge. Ah, lasciamo perdere, va. Oh, the error has increased. Oh, but has changed the sign. So, the convergence algorithm is trying something. Okay, now the error is very little. This flowsheet has inherent stability features. Allora, one thing is that we have a reaction limited by equilibrium. Second thing is that we have distillation without azeotropes. And these are things that can help you very much. Okay, we are almost there, guys. Bene. Mi merito un coffee. Adesso, il flowsheet converge, però l'ho sempre detto, un flowsheet che converge è una cosa, una simulazione con risultati sensati è un'altra. Quindi.
Allora, vediamo.
Vediamo se lo stirene che va a far fabbricare il polistirolo è effettivamente quello che volevamo. Ok, va bene?
Va bene.
We are producing
io ce l'ho pure.
97 kmol per hour of pure of styrene with the target purity.
Yes.
Feeding 120 kmol per hour of
etil benzene.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
So you see that the recycle enhances the selectivity because the reactor is fed with 188 kmol per hour of styrene. This means roughly that the selectivity would be a little higher than 50%, no more. But with the recycle, the selectivity increases.
Can I see your recycle schema?
That's it.
I have much more ethyl benzene in the recycle.
much more.
Yes, but the final results in the styrene stream are the same. And yes.
You have much more ethyl benzene in the
recycle. Yeah, I have 96 kilomole per hour of ethyl benzene in the recycle stream.
And also in the reaction feed.
And the reaction feed has 216 kilomoles per hour, yes.
So, allora, there are two possibilities, Simone. Questo vale per tutti. Or your reactors are behaving differently than mine. Mm-hmm. Or you are losing ethyl benzene in another point of the process.
Okay, I'll check if I lose it in vapor.
So let's start to see how much stuff I am losing in stream 60 and 68.
Allora,
ok,
60 e 68.
I'm not losing much stuff. I mean, in terms of ethyl benzene and styrene.
No, neither am I. I'm losing like 3 moles per hour.
So your reactors have a higher conversion than mine. So probably because you have them at a higher temperature.
Maybe. I think I switched them to 620 though.
No problems. No problems. This is an option that you have. Okay. Well, the point is that if I produce, Simone, the same styrene with the linear recycle, mm-hmm. then I am placing less work upon the separation columns.
Yes, and spending less energy.
That's why my flow sheet is slightly better than yours. You understand?
Yes, because it's cheaper to run.
Allora, this is very instructive. An Aspen Plus simulation has multiple convergence states. So some convergence points are just meaningless. But also when there are multiple convergence points with meaningful results, like in our case, there are still differences in terms of cost. Okay, then, if you look at the flow sheet, you see very plainly that you have 3,400 kilomoles per hour of steam going inside the process in this point, and 3,390 kilomoles per hour of water coming out from this point. Okay.
Yes.
So it seems very, very obvious, very natural to connect these two streams mm-hmm. and to close the cycle for water.
Okay.
Okay. Now, don't remember what we said in the very first lesson. If closed loops for a chemical species are potentially not stable. So it is better to provide an input and an output.
Okay.
Allora, in this case, we already lose water from the degassing of the decanter and also from the partial condenser of the first column.
Yes.
So actually, you see also from this balance, we need a make up for the lost water.
Yes.
Oh, another thing, but first of this time I have results loaded. Yeah, wonderful. Let's look at the actual composition of the water streams that outflow from the decanter. Allora, it's not pure water. okay?
Mm-hmm.
You cannot drink it. There are PPMs of toxic stuff. Allora, now, what is the point? When you face such a situation, you have to take a decision in advance. Do you have to purify this water before using it or not?
Oh.
Allora, for this case, I would say that we... Allora, it depends, as usual. If we have to use this water only to feed the reactors, I would say that the purification is not necessary. Because the contaminants of this water are the same chemicals that are consumed...
Present in the reactor. Reactors. Yes.
Okay, raga?
Mm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
The case would be different if, for example, how to say, if the reactor were not recirculated, but you have a once-through reactor without recycles, then you don't want to put the reaction product again in the reactor. Okay? Then maybe the water should be purified in advance. Another case would be if the reactor, the water is produced in the reaction and you want to use it for other things, okay? But then to use it for other things, you have to purify this water and so on and so on. Here we have a recycled reactor. So in principle, there is no problem to put the products in the reactor again. First thing. Second things, the water carries out the same things that already are in the reactor. So there are no problems in recirculating them in this way. Now, allora, the things is not complicated, but nevertheless, there are a couple of things to do in advance. Allora, first of all, we have to raise the pressure, okay? Because the injection of steam with the fresh feed is at 4 bar, while the discharge of water is slightly above atmospheric. So first thing, we need a pump. Allora. We do this connection. Okay. Allora, I'm using, okay, sì, i numeri sto usando, perfetto. 22, 24. Allora, FV stands for feed water. Don't ask me why. Mm. Now, guys, we need a makeup. Allora. Without adding another mixer, I can use the pump as a mixer because in Aspen Plus the pumps accept more than one input. See?
Okay.
Yes.
One or more. And this is the makeup for water. Okay, the makeup are more or less 7 kmol of water per hour. Allora, this water comes from a well or a water treatment plant. Anyway, I consider it in atmospheric condition. Selected discharge pressure for. Anyway, this is not the point because even if the boiler is at 5 bars, I regulate the pressure in the reactor with the mixer. So this is not the real source of our error. The real problems are in this. Now we need one heat exchanger to rise the temperature. Allora, I call it echo, because usually when you rise the temperature of water, the heat exchanger is called the economizer. Allora, with the economizer, you arrive just below the saturation temperature. So, we assume zero pressure drops, 5 degrees of subcooling, let's say. Okay. Now we need a boiler. Allora, I prefer to model the boiler with a flash tube block instead that with a heat exchanger. Anyway, this is just a matter of taste. Allora qua, bel bollitore.
Where do we find the boiler, sorry?
It's a flash tube block for me.
Thank you.
If you want to use a heat exchanger, use a heat exchanger.
Okay.
Now, how do I specify my boiler? Allora, in principle, I should foresee a block to boil up the water, so until the saturation temperature, and another block to heat up. Nevertheless, I specify this to produce steam at 200 degrees, and I'm done. Okay, temperature 200, pressure zero, that means zero pressure drops. And I connect to the steam that goes into the reactor. I connect source. Okay, now in this way, I am doing another loop. Okay, I expect that in this condition, the drain will be with zero flow. Okay. Now, there are a couple of things to do before letting run the simulation. Allora, first of all, we save with a different name. Second, we specify the second tier stream. Allora, that in my case, it is the steam exiting from the boiler. When you specify a tier stream, it must be with the stream that has the input compiled. So we have defined the tier stream, okay. Now we can do another thing to help this recycle to converge. Allora, the point is that I need to put in with the makeup just the water that I lose here and here. And here. Okay, because I have no other exit for water except for the drain. Okay. Now you can do like this. Allora, flow sheeting options, as usual, balance. We create a balance block. Mass balance number one is the only one. Enter blocks or streams to define mass balance envelopes. Allora, we define streams. Let's select the stream for the mass balance. Chi si ricorda che cosa vale l'inlet e cosa vale l'output? Allora, the inlet stream is the makeup.
Ok.
Ok, this is where this is the inlet point for water in our flow sheet.
Yes.
Now we have to list all the outlet points. So the first obvious outlet points is the drain. Okay.
Yes.
Actually, the drain is designed to pull water out of the cycle if you are putting in too much. Okay.
Okay.
So allora, the other outlet points, allora, it's, we have another three outlet points. The off gas from the decanter, the vapor from the first condenser, and probably also the distillate of the second column.
Okay.
Allora, 60 vapor, giusto? 60 vapor, 60 vapor, 54 vapor, ok. Ok, and I'm doing the calculation on water. Not on anything. Okay, I want to calculate, I want that Aspen Plus calculate the right makeup. Okay, guys. Now, what is the point? What is the point? Allora, if you check these options, update calculate variables, Aspen will continuously update the makeup. Okay. If you don't do this, Aspen will calculate the right makeup. But this value will only be a notification. Okay? Allora, let's try to check this option. And let's see what happens.
Okay.
Okay, I got errors, unfortunately. I got, I have that some blocks are not in balance. Allora, let's see what has happened. First of all, to the pump that recycles the tree benzene. Because this is a process block. Okay, we have a mass imbalance of 0.15%. Nevertheless, this pump carries what I expect it to do. The real problems are in this heat exchanger, you see. Because the specification is wrong. Allora, given the fact that in the water there are gas dissolved, Aspen doesn't manage correctly the specification. Okay, so we just select zero vapor fraction. That means saturated liquid. Okay. We do a selective reset of the block. Okay, and I still get an error where? Always in the boiler. Okay, probably because, again, Aspen Plus does not calculate correctly the temperature here. So let's specify this heat exchanger with this usual pressure temperature couple, because this is the safest way to specify it.
Okay.
Okay. We can raise the temperature up to, let's say, 100 degrees for now. Then we will check what are the exit conditions of the water. Okay. Allora, the boiler is not in mass balance because the recycle is not fully converged, and so there is a mismatch of 1 mole per hour. Okay, just that, don't worry. The mismatch is very, very little. Okay. Now, allora, we can reset the convergence block. Do like this. Convergence. Okay.
In my case, the pump P2 is okay.
Better.
I have other kind of problems.
In my case, the decanter is preventing me from running the simulation.
The decanter?
For reasons unknown, because it was working before.
You just reset the decanter.
I've resetted everything.
Not everything, the decanter. Allora, okay. I'm not reaching convergence because I don't have enough water in the cycle, see? I started out with the 3040 and I have 2900. Oh, okay. Now you see, I should put in a water makeup of 141 kilograms per hour. Okay. While my decanter, while my makeup is just 126. Okay, let's try to see what happens if I increase the makeup.
Qualcuno intanto mi può dire le specifiche del boiler?
200 gradi.
E pressione?
La stessa.
Ok.
Non mi fa resettare solo un blocco, mi permetti di resettare solo una tutto insieme?
Dipende da come è andata la simulazione. Quando la simulazione va molto male, il risultato è quello lì. Ok, guys, now I will try to make the simulation go allowing the balance block to update the water makeup, because I still have too few steam in the cycle respect to the beginning. Okay, now I don't get any more errors, only warnings. Nevertheless, there is still too few water in the cycle, see? Because now I'm making my system run with less than 3,000 kilomoles per hour steam instead of 3,400, okay?
Yes.
How can I go to the initial point? One way is to reset the convergence block, because I defined a tier stream that starts from 3,400. So in theory, if I reset the convergence, I'm telling Aspen Plus to start the calculation from 3,400. Now let's see if Aspen Plus has caught my hints. No. Allora, I have two options now. One option is to reset totally the simulation. The other option is to inject water manually in the system using the makeup.
Basing on the calculation of the mass balance that
we did. Disabilitating the mass balance.
Ah, okay.
I show you how. Allora.
Yes.
I uncheck these options and I put in more water than is needed. See? Allora, in the last calculation, there were 7.8. Okay. I start putting in 10. In this way, I will have a little buildup of water in the flow sheet. This build-up will stabilize when I make more water let out from the vapor in the decanter. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then my recycle has stabilized on 3,000 and 200 kilomoles per hour steam. more near to, sì, more near, nearer to the original quantity.
I don't understand why mine is 3,700, sorry.
It's too much.
Yes, I know.
Decrease the makeup and make it rerun.
Okay.
Okay, now I have two blocks out of convergence, but this is not the point, but this is quite normal when you do things in this way. I can just reset the block and let the simulation rerun and see what happens. Allora, why I have problems in the boiler and the ethylbenzene pump? Because these blocks sit exactly at the closure of the loops. These are the blocks that manage the tear streams. It's normal that convergence errors are on these blocks. Okay. A little too much water here. And still some error on the blocks. So I decrease the makeup. And I do another run. I still decrease the makeup. Okay. Now I update the water balance. Ce lo trovo. And see what happens. Okay, only warnings. I look up at these warnings. I have warnings on the water pump.